Welcome to Warn. Today's news is most possible SU-30MKIs, Super Sukhoi configurations. Indications in recent months suggest that the upgrade program for India's fleet of SU-30MKI fighters is finally gathering pace. The Indian Air Force, IAF, has so far placed orders for 272 aircraft, of which 50 were delivered by Russia in 2002 to 2004 and 2007. Another 222 are to be supplied by the HAL Corporation. Production under Russian license began at HAL's Indian facilities in 2004. So far, more than 200 planes have already been delivered, and the SU-30MKI is the most numerous of the multi-role fighters currently in service with the IAF. Even though the SU-30MKI is one of the most advanced of the Generation 4 Plus fighters in service with the IAF, the need for its upgrade is becoming ever more obvious. The first of the planes built to the current specification were delivered to India back in 2004. Since then, a lot of new technology has become available in Russia, India, and other markets, including advanced new radars, air-launched missiles and bombs. Retrofitting the plane with this new hardware can make it much more capable. In fact, the SU-30 platform itself is extremely well suited for all kinds of upgrades, from fairly conservative to the most radical, because the plane has a two-seater cockpit and can accommodate a lot of bulky and heavy additional equipment. For a long time, the only thing we knew about the proposed SU-30MKI upgrades was the name of the program, Sukhoi Super 30. There was no information about the technical specifications, timeline or costs. Commentators often confuse Sukhoi Super 30 with another upgrade program that aims to integrate the SU-30MKI with the air-launched version of the BrahMos anti-ship cruise missile. These are in fact two independent and unrelated projects. BrahMos will be installed on only 40 to 42 planes. The program has already reached a fairly advanced phase of flight testing to ascertain mechanical compatibility of the BrahMos-A air-launched missile with a reinforced SU-30MKI airframe. Live missile launches are due to commence very shortly. The Sukhoi Super 30 program, on the other hand, will be rolled out to the entire Indian fleet of SU-30MKI fighters. It has yet to begin in earnest, and up until recently, there was very little information about it in the public domain. There is a pressing need for speeding up the SU-30MKI program in order to restore the Indian Air Force's technological superiority over the Chinese. Essentially, India needs to pull off the same trick it did in the mid-1990s, when it responded to China's mass procurement of SU-27/30 fighters with the original SU-30MKI program. 2 decades on, India needs to respond to China's SU-35 and J-31 jets with the Sukhoi Super 30. Some experts says SU-30MKIs, Super Sukhoi, will equivalent to 5th-gen fighter jets in comparison to avionics and weapon control systems. Let's see what the possible updates are, my personal view. 1. Engine, ascertain L-31, SU-35 engine, or B-Saturn L-41, Saturn L-41 T-50 engine. 2. Radar, A. IRBISE passive phased array radar, developed by Russia, B. Updated Physotron Zook AEAESA radars, developed by Israel. 3. Updated software for jet handling, may possible open software, for future updates. 4. The suite also has 2 N036L-101L band transceivers on the wing's leading edge extensions that are not only used to handle the N036SH Pokosnik, Reaper, friend or foe identification system, but also for electronic warfare purposes. Computer processing of the X and L band signals by the N036 UVS computer and processor enable the system's information to be significantly enhanced. 5. The radar will reduce pilot load and make use of a new data link to share information between aircraft. The SU-30MKIs will have secure communication links to share data with all other friendly aircraft in the area, as well as airborne and ground-based control points. 6. Weapons, A. All new weapons near to 5th-gen fighter will be incorporated BMBDA Meteor C. All future missiles developed by DRDO, Astra, BrahMos-NG. Dajit Singh, a retired IAF Air Marshal and defense analyst, explained that there will be significant differences between the upgraded Super Sukhoi and the coming FGFA fighter jet. FGFA has some distinct features, which Super Su-30MKI will not have, said Singh. These include internal weapon-carrying bays to enhance stealth features, integrated internal fit of the electronic warfare suite, supercruise capability and inherent stealth design. Su-30 cannot be redesigned as a stealth aircraft, Singh continued. Any changes of the wing design and material to improve stealth would be very expensive and time-consuming and would be akin to a different design. Therefore, the FGFA project may not be cancelled in total in view of the Su-30 upgrade. Thanks for watching. I hope you like this news. Please share your views in comment box. Please like and share this video. Press subscribe button and bell for auto update to you regarding my channel World Action and Reaction News, Warn.